What's up, guys? Today we're gonna react to Namewee's new house, right? So this is his house in Johor. But before that, right, I have so much respect for Namewee and the fact that he is so creative, yet he hustled and he produced music videos so much faster than we produce property reviews. That is insane, right? And lately he has been pushing NFTs, he has been pushing a lot of social movement. Nothing but respect, but let's go. Oh, I like the green, man.
Yeah!马普的老家呢其实算是靠海的一个地方所以在以前英殖民时期的时候呢经常会有很多那些渔船啊货船啊在这边靠岸这个家呢就是阿公阿婆他们从海南岛来那么呢父母亲在六十年代开始做这个花山咖啡店的生意就只是一个小阁楼我们三个人挤在一起那时候的物价呢在这一带呢是蛮贵的不是十多钱只有华人有能啊
expensive houses, 10k. But you come to think of it, right? I think in this entire storyline, a few things to highlight. One of it is a lot of Malaysians don't know how lucky we are because we are part of the Commonwealth, therefore part of the British colonial penjelajahan. What is that? Is it right? Penjelajahan. Colonization. Penjelajahan. What's penjelajahan? Anyway, penjelajahan. We get the benefit of the technology, especially on infrastructure, like the drainage, the street lightings, the all these kind of things, right, are just awesome. And besides that, we have that proper land title system that is applied. So back then, even like 19 what they bought, right, it's all documented. So you can clearly tell who's the previous owner, who's the new owner and stuff like that. So that's the benefit of being in part of the Commonwealth system.
他在1976年虽然相隔了好几年而已但是已经接近50千买下了这间屋子
They bought at 50,000 The first owner was 10,000 5x really. It's like altcoin today
其实我在从小开始住这里的时候发现到很多问题因为毕竟它是五六零年代的屋子然后后来越来越严重了屋顶还会漏水补了一万次还是一直漏一直漏然后马路上高低的问题因为我们的家比较旧所以马路越建越高所以还会有淹水的问题其中最严重的水淹到我们的厨房甚至是我们的庭院
What I want to highlight here is old houses. A lot of people do always ask, like, what's the difference between new houses, old houses? The difference will be, like what you see here, if I were to spend another 1 million on fixing up the house, the infrastructure cannot change, the road width cannot change, the drain, you cannot add extra 2 feet to the road because the drain do not belong to you. And there's only so much control you have for your neighbor. If your neighbor don't want to build, then sorry lah. Right, so like you got biawa or whatsoever, that's pretty normal, especially in kampung areas like this. And that time, insurance policies do not cover flood. So after that, only, oh, you want to add, only we can add in, which is insane.
然后到我长大过后呢，我就一直想说，有一天我赚到钱了，我一定要好好的去整修这间家，因为毕竟这个是我从小到大的回忆，那我不想让他看他这样。
Do you know the line on top? Blocks. Those are van blocks. You know van blocks, then the window, wow, all these like super old, classic.
然后烂下去。再后来的时候，我们在大概2015年的时候就有开一个会议，讲说我们家里要装修，然后就开始在计算要花多少钱，再问各方面的意见。我们装修有时候很多人讲，你装修这笔钱不便宜的，因为你要拆，拆也要有拆工啊，建筑也要有一笔钱啊，你倒不如去外面买一栋。 直接租进去又省时又美观又有时代感，何必这样辛苦啊？所以每个人的观点都不一样。I
do agree. Why don't you just move out, get a better house with better infrastructure, everything new, and whatever cost is just adding on to the existing structure, right? To tear down and redo again. Because a lot of people don't know this, like if you put in this amount of money, right, that does not mean the valuation of the property is increased. Let's say I spend 100,000 to tear down the house, I spend another 500,000 to put on the house. That doesn't mean your house today is worth 600,000. No. Yeah, but plus everything is in cash. And it's pretty common last time, especially for Chinese, we get, oh, this uncle for money, the uncle got borrow money for renovation is a thing. The sad thing is in Malaysia, there's no proper renovation loan. There's no loan like, oh, I want to beautify my house is leaking. It's somewhat like a personal loan repackaged into a renovation loan.
我们在2019年开工嘛, 拆了结果没多久呢, 就2020年就新年了嘛, 那新年过后以为可以继续, 结果突然间就政府宣布MCO, 这些建筑业啊, 全部都不可以开工, 因为你这样子封的话, 材料放在那边, 有些会坏掉, 尤其是一些油漆啊, 各方面的东西啊, 导致那些我们本来预算好的成本呢, 是翻倍的。
But what he said when MCO happened, construction basically death sentence, because few things like all your workers cannot be around, then all your materials easily price increase 30%, 40%. For door frames itself, per piece is around 40% increase. And when you get quotations, like contractors are very sensitive towards time. So what they measure is always price, time, quality. Then only they arrange the humans, resources and things like that. Therefore, when it happened, right, lockdown, imagine this is for a house. Imagine if it's for an apartment that is construction fee is like 380 million. Lately, I think a lot of renegotiations are happening between the developers and the contractors because of this issue until today. They rather just burn the contract because if they were to complete everything, right, they will lose money. It's that insane. So, especially for those that is, like those that has not launched, still okay. So, but those that launch, price are locked in before inflation. And who will actually know that inflation will increase 20 to 30%? So basically, whatever they built is for free. Profit margin, insane. We should be doing things like this. Right? Should we just start a series like, before and after makeovers? Yeah. You see, this is this scene, right? This scene, this shot itself. No matter how changi your house can be, you are three stories or two stories, right? The surrounding is still like that. Single story still. Then you can see the drone pilot at the junction. Yeah, so you have the cables, the overhead cable, then you have the rumah papan at the side. And it's, yeah, the road is still so narrow. No matter how much you plow in, again, it's only for your own stay. Bank valuation not necessarily going to be high.
以前都是一模一样的，后来就是有些因为太多年了， 有些人已经装修改变， 可是它基本上还是就是那个感觉。 那这个屋子的，
you look at the road level, right? To the house level, it's the same. But if you look into normal by right, it should be higher than the road. Yeah, but because of old houses, when there are potholes at the road, they will fill up the road again and again and again. So if you see like those old streets in KL, some of the shops, right, are the road level is half the shop. Yeah, especially like those in KL city center, a lot of them. So it's going to have a lot of problem, especially drainage. Bangsa also got, PJ also got. So these kind of typologies are pretty common around Malaysia. And this is individual title household, and you can see no matter how nice your landscape, right, you will have a street, the stop sign at the side. Then you have the street light lamp there. Then you, no matter do how nice, right, then the wire is still there. Ah.
它比较高难度的是它的铁工，那个篱笆的部分呢，在英殖民的时候很流行的那种铁花。这个年代已经没有什么人在做这个东西。我们到处问，找铁匠，找那些做篱笆的，也没有人。So
these are cast iron or mild steel kind of materials. And last time, in order to compare wealth, everybody was comparing gates. Yeah, I don't know. So this is how I brought up. So when they were choosing the gate, it's a family meeting one. Yeah, so those like in smaller areas, it needs to be stainless steel, aluminium, then it's like super reflective. Then it needs to be in a curved manner where it's like a sun. Yeah, all this kind of thing. Yeah, it's no matter how scientific is it, I don't know. This looks cool until you need to repaint them. Yeah.
在做这种东西，结果很幸运的 ，last minute 的时候给我们找到一组人，就是叫 Bill Gates，不是那个 Bill
Gates，是那个很
built、很 beautiful、很 built 的 gate，而且他们还 sponsor 我，然后我也很感谢啦，就是这些公司呢有这样的坚持，做回当年的一些东西，然后把回忆就还回给我。
A lot of terrace houses install this on their upper floors, and there are a lot of incidents where they say these that are meant for safety trap them inside during fire. Yeah, so these kind of things are, I don't know where they adopted it from, but to a certain extent of fire security, it's not very safe. Plus, a lot of people will think that, oh, they cannot open up, right? So for those professional thieves, they open like that. So a lot of people try to open up the door from the frame itself. Actually, you just open from the joint.
因为这个地方的治安呢，平时不是很好，所以因为这种偷偷看的感觉呢，就有人发明了，你可以看到别人，可是别人看不到你的一个系统。连接中。讲华语的，
这马来人来怎么办？连接中啊，不对。 Hello, hello, 你好，我是来抢劫的，麻烦请开门。OK，可以，我可以抢劫了。
But that's the entire spirit between individual title and stratified title. The fact I spend so much money on the new house, but any stranger can just come to my front door and knock, right? I think that's rather disturbing. I know I grew up in this kind of house as well. But in a stratified, at least there's another gate system before they come into the compound. So this is that constant debate I have between stratified and landed individual title one. So
在以前的那个英国人留下来的这个家的设计里面，一定会有一个东西叫做天井。现在的家里面应该比较少看到。所谓天井呢，就是在家里面呢有一个地方是可以看到天空的。那我们也把这个天井的这个旁边呢改成了饭厅。那在这个吃饭的时候呢，就可以看到树、看到花，又有太阳，又有自然风吹进来，叫人生多大的享受。So
what he said just now, it's that central courtyard. So usually for a house, especially in Malaysia, we are more used to terrace houses, and the only light source will be the front and the back. Therefore, the center portion of the house is always very dark. So it's also called an air well. It's also called the skylight or whatsoever, central courtyard. So when it's a courtyard, it means it's bigger. And just now there was a B-roll that shows it was a larger space, especially in those Melaka and Penang kind of shop houses. So when you have super long, then the problem is actually darkness because there's no light source. Only they start putting in all these courtyard gardens. And because it's a bit more pleasant in terms of ventilation and daylighting, therefore it becomes that activity spot, the more active spot lah.
然后有一个烤箱，然后一个微波炉，这三个电器呢，浑然天成的装在这个橱里面。
I just realized that no matter how old school or how vintage you want your house to look, kitchen is always the most modern space.
The appliances.
And now like you look into the basic appliances, right? Now the main debate for all housing developers is how many plug points are you supposed to provide?
这个是号称以前古代人的冰箱，为什么呢？它通风，东西不会坏，可是没有冰。
He mentioned that this was the old fridge. And last time when I still have impression of the old house lah, moving into a house need not to have anything. The tenant's requirement for a space is so bare minimal. Now the bare minimum is aircon, the bare minimum is with TV, the bare minimum is with water heaters. Then now you need internet, and now we need fully furnished only I'll take up the space. Well, that illustrates the trend of renting instead of ownership anymore. Yeah, so landlord is going to be a little bit more difficult to be.
去那古代的那种四合院的屋子啊，或者中国老房子，或者马来西亚巴巴吉尼亚那种老家里面都会有这个木椅在这里。他是从海南岛呢，是去到新加坡的，然后去到新加坡过后，他就想要来马来西亚创业。If
you notice, there's a groove line above and there's a groove line below. They use the similar groove lines, and these are just to break up. Most likely, this is the termination point for the structure. With the brickworks, just to let you know. Because always when concrete joins with brick, that area is very high prone to cracks. So they just somewhat decorate it a little bit.
这个位置呢，本来是我家的客厅。那因为后来后面的部分呢，我们已经改成两层楼了，所以想要把厨房呢移来前面。那这个算是这个家那时候在讨论在设计的时候一个很大胆的尝试，因为我。What's
very weird here is this central beam in the center. You look at this front ceiling. And the back ceiling is actually very high. But you look at this massive beam cutting across the entire space. So old houses, I can understand because the technologies are a little bit old. They will always over-provide in terms of structural support. But this is a new building. So I can anytime just remove this beam and immediately the space is all opened up. And again, if you look into the details, like above the room doors, there's still all these fan blocks. There's a few possibilities where a lot of older houses, the rooms do not have windows. So the only source of window is the window to the living room, the window via the door and things like that. Yeah.
我们在跟设计师讨论，还要跟我爸爸妈妈沟通，他们很难接受这件事情。那为什么要这样呢？其实有几个原因啦。因为如果
The flooring for the kitchen, right, is nice and all with the motifs, but it's a nightmare to look for replacement. What if one piece of it cracked, right? I don't know where to buy, and it may stop in production. You cannot get the same piece or the same series. So what we usually do in development is we will provide you with whatever the house and another maybe 5% or 10% in terms of tiles. Because even if it's the same series, it will not look the same because some may age a little bit, some may go patina a little bit. And if it's natural stones, good luck. Yeah.
也就是我们家的历史.
You look at those switches. Those are the real old school switches. Whew, those are the best, man.
走廊，为什么叫历史走廊呢？因为
Again, you look into that van block on the beam. Clearly, that piece is not required. Meaning, that piece right there is only for decorative purposes. It's just imagine if that piece is not there. So a lot of designers use or architects use this to differentiate a space to another. So when you go into another dimension, right, there's this barrier you go through. Oh, I'm in a different space altogether. So that's a design intent. Structurally, it need not to be there.
Hey. 我们家里呢就拍了很多照片啊，还有一些纪念品啊，还有去各国玩啊，一些收集很多东西回来。所以我们为了要收藏这些东西呢，我们特别制作了这个L型的历史走廊。You
look in this space, right? If not for the light, this space is going to be so dark, and all the doors are connecting to this space itself, so there's no source of light on it. Yeah, and imagine, so I think it's a damn good move that they make this into a corridor. Somewhat it revives the activeness of the space. If not, it's just going to be a corridor. And I always think that corridors are the worst space in a house. It means that from a dining, I need to walk to the living space via a corridor, right? I think it's a waste of space. So there are a lot of ways to join space together. Need not a corridor. It's not a hospital.
这里呢就是主人房，就是爸爸妈妈的房间了。之前是很窄很乱的，因为他们衣服真的太多，东西又舍不得丢，塞塞塞，让我妈妈的特色就是塞。然后我爸爸也是很喜欢塞，不过两个人塞的东西不太一样，所以我就决定呢做一个到天花板的壁橱，给他们塞到。除此之外呢，我们还有做了一个梳妆台啊，输出，就给他们两个在那边办公。
Sometimes I wonder, right, how feasible it is to have a workstation in your bedroom. Let's say when you have your wife sleeping, tak mungkin you work one mah. Yeah, you can work in silence, but the mouse click 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 click. How to?
Right. Makes sense if you're renting.
Yeah, you're right. It only makes sense if you're renting a space for your own you alone, right? With another person in the space, I don't think it's gonna work lah. So I would encourage, right, instead of that, I would dedicate out a workspace outside. But you can see that very consistent partition. Like, you know, usually we do a skirting, they do a whole 1 good meter around the entire house. So it's indirectly splitting the whole house. I think makeover guys also use this technique where we split the walls by half and we use wallpapers to be exact. So there are a lot of better choices of wallpaper that gives you that 3D feel. So this one is all timber. It's going to cause a bomb. And because of things like that, the plug points locations becomes very awkward. Because if you look into plug points location, it's always another like 450 mm above floor level. Skirting sticks around 150, so you get a good, right? But then when you have this kind of treatments, all needs plug points needs to go up. Then you see it on the table, all needs to go up there.
它这个房间还有一个很大的问题，就是它的厕所非常狭窄，因为它本来的建筑的结构就是这样子。可是我们必须要在仅有的空间呢，去让它比较舒服一点。
If you guys are moving into a new house and you really have the budget, right? A space that I do not want to save at all is the bathroom. And most of the time, I did this myself in the two new houses that I've just renovated. The marble top, it's a space changer ultimately, right? So you get that solid surface where you can actually just sit on it, right? Instead of the sink itself, that changes the whole persona of the toilet. Then the mirror size, a small mirror like that, I don't know why people use that, right? Last time, no money, I understand. But now, if you have a little bit more budget, go as big as possible. Your wife will thank me later.
这个厨呢，不要开玩笑， 爸爸娘惹时代的那个厨， 这个厨是非常非常有历史价值的。 我觉得那种在马来西亚如果有玩古董的朋友呢， 看到这个厨应该会冲动。
Again, if you look into the panels, because of the wall panels, you can look at the wall panels and you, because you can see that groove at the edge, at the connection point between the panel and the wall, that made the cupboard unable to stick. I know this is a loose fitting kind of cupboard, and those were the design philosophies back then. We call it a slightly more Art Nouveau movement, where there's a lot of decorative elements to anything they do. But after Industrial Revolution, everything needs to be easily produced, and also these kind of things we don't see anymore. But I just want to highlight, if you have OCD, right, the cupboard can never join to the wall, and there will just be a gap in between. Imagine you need to clean that. Oh.
那这里呢，就是我的客房。
Oh, I like that clock, man.
当初为什么要想到要做一个客房？因为其实之前呢，本来是阿公的房间，可是阿公已经去世了。然后我们的整个厕所的概念呢，也是就是走回。You
look at the beads that's at the window. Those are using seashells, and it's very common. Like a lot of houses will have that, and it's always that divider between the dining and kitchen. There's this small space that you need to walk through, and they put this as the partition. So in a very fancy manner, it's called sense of entry, but it just makes you know that, oh, somebody is in the space lah. And the worst thing is when the end loose, everything drops. Oh my god.
以前复古的样子，你看这个墙壁一砖一瓦，就是以前的四方砖。这个厕所呢，一开窗呢，就可以看到植物，而且还有这个。
So if you notice, the size of the tile indirectly illustrates the vintage feel of. So last time, we call this mosaics. Mosaics are just small, small cubes, and they really put one lid on a masking tape, and they will just tape like that to the concrete. Right? So that's how they laid last time. But now, all these are made, so big tiles like this, they are printed on them in that smaller size tile, just to make you have that vintage feel and things like that. It's nice, and I like that they use different size of tiles between the shower area and the normal area for the toilet. So that gives that contrast in terms of feel. Again, in architecture and design, we always want to demarcate out different spaces.
自己打开的没有？这个非常先进的这个马桶系统，多多赞助了。其实这个多多这个 brand 呢，我们经常在高级的 hotel 或者一些高级场所都会看到。
Only people that has traveled a lot, and when you need to renovate your house, right, you will get to know brands of toiletries. Like when, I still remember when I start reviewing properties, a lot of people don't know the brand to their WC and basin. So when I go into a property, but just by looking at the spec of the toiletries, I already know what level this property is in. So a lot of people still think that Johnson Suites are the best. They are okay, but like Toto, Grohe and stuff like that are the... So if you look into the roof here, that center space there, that would be the courtyard space. Yep. So indirectly last time, they believed that when you collect water into the house, it's good for wealth. Right, all money, tree all come. But again, no matter how nice you design, you look at the boundary between this new house and the next door house. They still use zinc roofing. So this, in this illustration, you can see the zinc roofing, you can see the clay roof tiles roofings. And you can see that at the edge, like this is the top, right, the cover, cement, everything. It was meant for ventilation, but as the wind's getting insane, there's a lot of bugs that can come in. Water actually seeps through like that. That's therefore leaking. That's why a lot of people might as well just pa everything, right? So some architectural.
特别感谢Mirai，这个对我们来讲是很重要的，因为麻婆呢，除了供电有问题。
Okay lah, he is not a professional in construction, but these are non-compliance in terms of safety in the construction site. right? First of all, they don't have helmets, they don't wear gloves, they don't have safety boots, they are not attached safety-wise. And what happens if one of them fell? That's the worst thing. But in Malaysia, yeah lah, we don't really have enforcement for those kind of things. So that's very unfortunate.
就是我的家本来是一层楼的，可是因为我们的东西不够放，地方不够睡，然后而且有一点贪玩，所以我就屁股痒盖了二楼，上面就是我的房。So
what I like the designer, what the designer did, right, is actually like they retain the language of that window cover. So those comes with a function. And number one, it prevents water from seeping through in the window. Number two, it's somewhat sun shading. The vertical fins are just for aesthetic, but the horizontal one until today is still retained in a lot of landed properties. I like it, man. So you see all these vent areas. So as a neighbor, right, like if you want to do structures like this, a lot of people think you got money you can do, but you need actually the municipal's approval before you can do things like that. Now, actually I have a courtyard that I can enjoy myself in, but now when the next door is 3 story high, right? Hello.
可以看到我在看他在冲凉。 那这个二楼麻烦在哪里呢？其实第一个麻烦就是要跟政府申请，因为我们这里全部都是单层的，经过蛮久才批准的。那这里呢是我的一个小小的工作室啊，一个studio这样子。因为平时如果回来麻坡时间比较长的话，要做音乐，还是要有一个地方啊，不可能在马路上面唱，然后给邻居 complain 的嘛，你知道这里很小而已。然后这些就是刚刚我挂好的海报，所以我做一些电影啊、一些专辑啊，他们有把它裱起来，拿回来也不知道放。
Imagine if we run this channel for another 5 years, right? So it's going to be like a 10 years anniversary. And we look back at episode 1, right? Absolute insane.
因为回来麻婆呢，对我来讲，就是可以让我好好睡觉休息的时刻。所以这个床对我来讲真的很重要。那我的房间的最难的地方就是因为它是两层楼。那盖两层呢，这里就是全新的状态。你就是要弄到它跟其他那些旧的部分要融合在一起。
Again, because I think their plug points are pretty unique. So those decorative ones where you switch on the main light and fans, they still retain the old black one. But then for sockets, like for the TVs and in the kitchen, they integrate in at the far end, they integrate into the cabinet itself. Those are very expensive. Because they just requires a lot of detailed works. Somebody needs to measure accurately, drill, put that one, then only lay the cables behind. And if you want to replace again,
然后还有值得一提呢，就是我的马桶，就因为这个豆豆呢，它占住我们全家马桶里面最贵，就是我的厕所的马桶。当你一进去的时候，早上莫名其妙就是睡眼惺忪，走进马桶的时候，突然
，You can see the reflective. That's a ventilation system back then, mechanical ventilation. So to make your because always right bedroom, the toilet air is not as great. So if you don't have a mechanical ventilation, the window, your room will actually smells like whatever you just passed out in the toilet lah.
那我整个房间最神奇的东西还有什么呢？我先示范给你们看啊。小欧管家，请关灯。噔噔。
You see those parody where they mock this kind of system? Where there's one that's in the treadmill, then he lost control. Then got one that got locked outside of the house because it's raining. Then the audio cannot connect. And the funniest thing, right? A lot of developers actually call their product smart home. That's because they have a Google Home device. Yeah, so that's why they call it smart lah. But definitely this is going to be the future, but our English, I don't know whether can make it or not lah. Right, so if you don't know how to speak Mandarin, 小欧管家, habis.
我们装修呢，我也特地就来维护这个绿意的这个感觉，因为我觉得我们每天生活啊，除了在家里面之外，我觉得需要一点生机，不想整个家就死气沉沉，然后都是洋灰，都是钢骨水泥的感觉。为了符合这个家这个 colony 的主题呢，我们也特地找了很多南洋的那种植物啊，来混搭植物。那只是要如何把那个颜色啊，或者是它的种类啊，很好的分配。 跟白色哦，这个是一个很大学问。
You see, in order to hide that lamppost, they put in so much of these leaves, right? And that was a crucial thing whenever we do feng shui calculation. Last time I still remember there's one sifu that comes to my house. No good. What is no good? The palang, you see the berhenti sign? Right, that is in the pathway of your entrance. Then we need to apply to somewhere, relocate it. Or some like, if you notice like certain Chinese houses, their door, the front foyer or the level, right, it's tilt to a degree. Yeah, it's just to prevent all this hindrance to the entrance. Yeah, so I'm Chinese like that.
那这个家呢, 装修的主题呢, 有一个很重要的...
Again, windows like this look super cool until it rains. Really, I'm like logic. So like you have a window swings like that. Just imagine when it's raining, right? These are just a nightmare to maintain. But the fact that he still choose to go with it, right? Ooh, lots of respect. And in order to break the scale of the wall, you look at all these roof lines at the side of the doors. What's that steel thing here at the end? That's usually the exhaust for the kitchen.
Oh, yeah, the kitchen. The specialty is this window. But 爸爸呢就把我们从小到大的奖杯，包括我妈妈的、我爸爸自己的、我的、我弟弟、我妹妹的赢得的一些奖杯放在这里，目的是什么呢？就是好练哦。
I realize this kind of culture of having all these kind of things at home, right, are slowly fading, right? I used to have a cupboard like this as well, but when visitors come to the house, then there's a ice-breaking thing. But how often do we this kind of culture is really like dying, really, right? Yeah. Like so many property reviews that we went to, there's no display. Or even they display their Iron Mans and fabrics, right?
Hey, 这里呢就是我以前的房间的位置，然后现在变成什么停车场，因为我们发现到之前我们的车不够停啊，差不多可以停三辆车加三辆摩托。它这个车房的特色呢，就是它虽然是也是新的，然后可是我们保留了一些铁花还有封砖的部分，就是以前的建筑会有的东西。然后里面呢突然间还停着一辆很复古的。
You know how they do this? They actually imprint. That's why it's called concrete imprint. That's this thing where they so it's actually one flat piece of concrete just that they print on top of it. Then there's another type where they call broom finished. Usually the pathways for your parks, they have these grains. They just use this broom to actually just scrub through. Yeah, that's why it's called broom finished. It's not brush finished.
I thought it was like
No, where got so changi, bro?
Because the whole design is very old, but we added a electric door, so we can go
in. Wow, there's a roller shutter for the house, way.
Door lock down, then we can get out. Don't get out, get people taken away.
And you realize, right? He talks a lot about security. Like you have a roller shutter. So again, it's only limited to the boundary of your property. Anything exceed that, like. You cannot stop me from going over to your roller shutter and knock the door. There's really nothing or no law saying that I cannot. And that's the sucky part. I know a normal person wouldn't go and do that, but... And you look at the height of this wall. It's a human height. And it's so easy to... If there's any case, ends up, usually this would be all the... They smash all the kacha bottle, then they attach on top, then or they put barbed wires, then it ruins the entire aesthetic of the house. But another thing, like this car porch is like, if you look into the drone shots, it's open up like that and it's tilt. So you can see on the surface of the roof here, I think it's called a fascia. They still treat it with paint, but it will not last long. Really? Because the problem of Malaysian house is intense rain and intense sunlight. Wow, so if you need to go through all that, right? Wow, it's not easy.
然后才放你进去，这个是我们住在这边的求生之道。
Yeah, so you can see that there are actually restrictions on the distance between the road to the first wall of your house. Yeah, a lot of people was then always curious that why can't I just build up all the way? Actually, you can't. It's under this law called Uniform Building Bylaw. I forgot which year. Yeah. And if you have budget again to your mansion or landed property, go for wall lights. That really adds dramas to your house itself. Especially blank walls. Like you see all those, this space becomes so gempak because of the lights.
经历了那么多，整个多灾多难，到最后呢，终于做完了。在这里呢，我要感谢很多参与这个 project 帮我一起完成这个屋子的人，包括我们的水工阿邦、电工阿爽、水泥工阿彩、瓷砖工阿秀，还有我们的
everything starts with R，R秋啊。然后最后呢，
我也要感谢所有赞助我们、帮助我们完成整个 project 的朋友，因为如果没有他们呢，可能这个屋子就没有办法完成了。
Wow. So a few things, right? So I think this the first debate is whether is it worth it, right? If I to have this budget of, I think it easily is going to cost $1 million, right? If it's $1 million spent on a location like that, and the valuation at max for the neighbor is 800,000. So that's something that everyone needs to know. It's this method of valuation. So valuation, it's a process where the bank verifies the price on your property in when you want to take a loan or when you want to pay taxes. This process is rather tricky because they do not entirely take all renovation costs into consideration. So if, even if you spend $1 million on a location that is only 500,000 for your neighbor, it's very hard to justify if a next owner is going to buy your house at $1 million. Even if he's willing to pay that $1 million, he cannot take the loan up to $1 million. So that's something that a lot of owners need to understand. But if it's for very personal reasons, if it's for very emotional reasons, then by all means, right? Then a renovation process is one crazy process, especially if you need to relocate the old family. Because conveniently, a lot of people will just say that, hey, just get an old house in SS2, tear down and build again. It's not easy at all, especially if it's a family home. So you need to debate in between family members, the color, the space, who gets which room and whatsoever. And it's okay if money is not an issue, but if money is a budget is a huge issue, right? Those kind of debates, usually family dispute and all, like, oh you. And moving houses as well. So this is for those who thinks that like very, I'm going to rent forever. Because you're going to rent forever, you will not hoard things. So it's a good and bad thing. Like if you hoard stuff, then old houses like this makes a lot of sense. And there's always storeroom and there's always a place to call home or whatsoever. But if you rent houses, right, you move every year, you always got to keep light and easy. And that's the spirit of the space, I realized. Like I can give you a space with 3 planes. XYZ, right? Floor area with a height. But what builds the space is actually the furnitures. But what builds the memory in the space is all the photographs, the pictures, the items that they collect throughout the years. Those give spirit to a particular space. It may be sucky or dark or moist or whatsoever, right? But it's memories. So that's the main difference when we see a lot of new houses. It's a sales gallery, it's a show unit until the photographs are attached to the house. Yeah, so that's something that we try to hack in the makeover guys. Shameless plug. Then also, I think it's a trick that I've learned after doing renovation a few times. It's to get someone accountable for the project site. I will encourage to get a project manager for a construction site. So whenever I do anything, there will be a guy that I can whack. Because in terms of communication, right, I will need to deal with all subcons, especially for specific trades like the carpenters, the concrete workers, the electric cable person, the door person, the aluminium person. Construction is not difficult during execution, it's during planning. Which trade comes in the space first? And it's always they try to mark territories, which means that the concrete person comes in and lay the concrete finish already, only the carpenters come in to build on top. Then they will say that, hey, why this table not nice? Because the leveling of the concrete not nice lah. After they lay all the concrete, only the electric guy comes and drill the wall to put in the cable, then need to fix and patch all again. Can't you just lay during the casting of the concrete? So a lot of these kind of things you need to really go through unless you hire a project manager. A lot of people will just try to save that 10%. Of that project management fees, I would encourage you to do so lah. But overall, the fact that he is okay to spend this much of money, right, for the parents' house, I think that's admirable. That's so freaking cool. And the fact that I have a portfolio of properties, right, I have not spent a dime on my own house. So I really need to consider that. Stop being a freaking capitalist, right? Yeah, so I think that's why why I really love real estate. A property means different things to different people. It's an investment tool to me. It's my career, but to them it's a place that hosts all memories. And I don't know about you guys, a lot of KL people now, they complain they got no kampong to go back to. But overall, cool, dope execution. But I think after his NFT sales, I think all of these costs are covered lah. So another advice to a lot of people is to go on progressive billing. Fix the quotation. When you get a contractor, how much is this property is going to cost? 1 million. Then in 1 million, have specifications, like what the contractor is supposed to do. Build this counter up to 4 feet. All this needs to be specified. If not, it's going to be a VO, variation order. Contractors will always tell you, hey, this one we didn't put in. This one on site, we didn't foresee this to happen. That's why we need to add on more cost, add on. Not to diss any contractors, but that's how they make money. And I think that's all for this round. Thank you very much for watching. I guess this is going to be a permanent series soon. Do let us know whose house you want us to react to or to for me to check it out. But I think it's going to be a very nice series. Like, we get ourselves entertained and get educated at the same time. Cool. So see you guys. And if you really like this episode, like it, share it, and even subscribe for more information like this. Hit that notification bell and I will see you guys on the next time. We'll be right back.